love to cuddle them. Aww. Ooh, okay, okay. Not cool, guys. Mammals. Mammals are not the most species-rich group of animals on Earth. There are 6,000 species of mammals currently listed, but this number is a drop in the bucket compared to the roughly 1 million arthropod species described. And that's just one from the invertebrates. It seems like being spineless is a popular choice. Even among our fellow vertebrates, though, fish species number above 30,000, reptiles have a bit over 10,000, and birds are around that much. The mammals are not winning in the species number game. But despite that, mammals have become a rather dominant life form on Earth. They've been dominating the land since 66 million years ago. This era is also known as the Cenozoic Era, or the Age of Mammals. Granted, it did take a mass extinction to make mammals dominant. It took down 3/4 of the world's plant and animal species, along with the dinosaurs. If that didn't happen, in a parallel universe, us intelligent dinosaurs would be on DinoTube right now. Don't forget to dino subscribe, hit the dino like button with your dino claws, and let's not forget dino comment. Let's get back to our main topic. There are so many wonderful things to know about mammals. Take the start of mammal life. Look at this little one. They're playful and troublesome, but mom is there to watch over them. With patience. Lots of patience. The word mammals comes from the Latin word mamma, meaning breast. This ties to the mammary gland uniquely found in mammals. This gland produces milk, which is a liquid food usually given from the female to her offspring. All mammals have mammary glands and produce milk. This milk is very nutritious to the young one, and they will continue to drink the milk until they are to be weaned. Young mammals need a lot of energy, after all, to grow up, move around, and frequently stay warm. To stay warm, a lot of mammals will also make use of hair or fur, which is a great insulator. All of this fluffy, soft goodness is made of a protein called keratin. This protein is one of the toughest proteins that an animal can produce. It's not limited to mammals. It's also found in a bird's beak, the scales of a crocodile, the shell of a tortoise, and more. However, hair is specific to mammals. Mammals are the only ones who turn keratin into hair. Like this male lion just flaunting his mane. This mane does more than just serve as a good scarf, it helps protect the male from attacks to the neck. It's also a signal to the ladies. The condition of the mane is related to his testosterone levels. Generally, male lions with a thick and dark mane are considered to be fitter, in better health, and way more attractive to the females. So not only does his mane help protect his neck, it also serves as a wingman. It should be known all mammals have hair or fur at some point in their lives, but this hair can come in different forms. From the type we're most familiar with, soft, to the quills of a porcupine. Porcupine quills are still made of keratin. They're considered an adapted version of hair. In this case, adapted for defense. But at least they're still covered in something that looks kinda like hair. Check out this animal, the pangolin. The scales on its back, they're also made of keratin. They're the only known species of mammal that have these scales. The pangolin is a mammal equivalent of a tortoise. It puts all its hopes for survival on defense. Heck, it's worse than a tortoise, it doesn't even have teeth. It's also got bad vision to boot. One of the things it relies on instead is hearing. Which brings us to the next topic. Many mammals rely on their hearing to survive, especially these smaller ones. At the slightest sound, they hop away. It's a useful thing to be able to hear prey running or danger coming. All mammals have three bones in the middle ear called ossicles. These bones serve to transmit sound from outside in the air to the inner cochlea. Basically, they pass the sound waves onwards. We have them, and they are the smallest bones in our body. These three bones help mammals hear a wider range of sounds, especially high-frequency ones, like the sound of birds. For this tiger, hearing is its most developed sense. It's able to hear sounds at a much higher frequency than us. Their ears are also able to swivel around, searching for where the sound came from. All these facts we've just talked about are certainly some very interesting mammal specialities. However, perhaps more importantly, mammals are some of the most interesting animals because their greatest threat lies amongst themselves. As humans, we find mammals fascinating and intimidating. Many of them were a real danger, and then again, some are uncannily similar to us. Heck, we share 97% of our DNA with orangutans. We have more than 90% of our DNA in common with other mammals. We also ride them, hunt them, capture them, cull them to protect ourselves, use them, eat them, and keep them as pets. Many species of mammals are in the endangered list, and many are threatened and vulnerable. The reasons behind this cannot always be detached from our influence. But we are also able to protect these animals better than ever before, if only because we understand them better. We can do something to help them, even if it just means being a bit more eco-friendly. So that's Lights Out for now. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and bye! Thank you.